So I'm James Dixon, I'm 21, and I'm from Coventry. Yeah, basically what I do is I live and breathe martial arts. I personal train and teach classes in martial arts, so MMA and jiu-jitsu mainly. One day I do hope to eventually make an income from fighting itself.
Okay, here I'm with James Dixon. James trains out of the Lions Gym and is currently undefeated at 2 wins and no losses. James, how you doing today, mate?
I'm feeling wicked.
Tonight you're fighting for a title. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, I'm fighting for the February title. Found out about January that I'll be up for it, so raring to go.
Excellent, excellent. You've got a big smile on your face there. So obviously your mental preparation seems like it's gone pretty well. Tell us a bit more about the physical. How's training been going?
Training's been wicked. Training with Andre, Jimmy, you know, down at the Rough House. You know, it's hardcore, but you know, I grin and bear it, and here now.
Excellent. Well, look, like I said, you know, you've got the title on the line. You're undefeated. Obviously, I'm sure you're hoping that that's going to continue. So there's very little left to say, James, apart from best of luck for tonight, and we hope to see you practicing your stuff in the cage later.
And the first challenger to enter the octagon into the blue corner. Let's hear it for James Dixon. This title contest is fought over 5 3-minute rounds.
Gents, you both know the rules, you both know what I expect. Amateur rules, no heel hooks, no spine locks, no knees to the head, and no use of the elbows. Protect yourselves at all times, obey my instructions at all times. If you want to touch gloves, do so now. Back to your corners.
Referee Leon Roberts saying obviously that kick was fine. And these kicks are coming at some velocity.
I've got to be honest, most of these fighters, they seem to have this switch in their head where they can turn off pain. And unfortunately, it's a limited time frame. He's comfortable, he's happy. Dixon's not up in the clinch and he can pick him off bit by bit by bit.
This is the way Aiden Lee wins this fight. If Aiden Lee's going to win this fight, it'll be in this manner. But James Dixon, unabashed.
I think Dixon's made of bricks, you know. He's just taking these shots and just not bothered. There's no facial expression, there's no flinch.
Nothing at all, and that's a nice shot underneath. And a nice leg kick as well. Lee knows he's in a fight now. With the two clinch up. See, and once again, fighters were clinched then for 1 second, 2 seconds. Straight away, Dixon's turned it around to his advantage. He's got his man pushed up against the cage. Exactly everything that you want to see from a title fight here. Two great fighters giving it their all. Four hard rounds into the fifth. It may just be a matter of who wants it enough. All on that. Straight in for the takedown. Surely this is planning. But once again, in this range, this is where Dixon's dangerous.
Yeah, he smothers him, doesn't he?
Some nice body head ground and pound. And we see with the shorter rounds. Referee Leon Roberts giving a bit of a warning for a heel to the kidneys there from Lee. But from Dixon's point of view, and as we said before, the thing with these amateur fights is with these shorter rounds is one takedown sometimes is enough. Dancing around the outside as James Dixon, as Aiden Lee throws everything flashy that he's got left. And that's the end of a fantastic title fight.
Let's have a massive, massive round of applause. Yeah. What a fantastic, fantastic fight. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, after five hard-fought rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards, and the judges have rendered a split decision. Okay, judge number one scores the bout 48-47, Dixon. Judge number two scores the bout 47-48, Lee. And judge number three scores the bout 49-46 in favour of your winner and new Fight UK champion from the blue corner, James Dixon. But let's have a massive, massive round of applause. Let's hear it for a very
So I first discovered MMA when I was about 15 years old. I seen The Ultimate Fighter on TV. It was Channel 5 USA, I believe. And yeah, it was The Ultimate Fighter, UK versus USA. And literally as soon as I seen it, I fell in love. I actually, my mum hated MMA. She had a bit of a warped opinion. And I literally had to secretly watch it in my room. Otherwise, if she found out, she would kind of get a bit angry. So it was quite an interesting kind of way of discovering it, really.
What's his striking like? I don't really see it.
Fucking dire.
Well, it looks mostly like a gypsy kind of guy, but it's not very good.
She's high-fived
you. Well done.
Smelliest raps you'll ever meet, or see, I should say.
Bust it on Tim's knee last Thursday.
Just knew them to be sweaty, and they slipped in. Don't fit unless it's wet.
I don't think my gloves are wet, man. Feels better, you can lie. I hate when my gloves are dry and stiff.
Yeah.
I prefer when they're wet, man.
Yeah. The main motivation would probably have to be my dad. As a kid, he always told me stories. You know, he was in the army. Always told me stories of, as a biker, I'd get into these street fights and I was some tough guy. And obviously, every kid always wants to be and grow up to be like their dad. So that was probably my main inspiration. But also, I mean, I guess I've always kind of had a knack for trying to be the alpha male. Like, having two older brothers probably does that for you. I've always been quite competitive and wanting to be that alpha male. So having that really kind of, you know, drove me, I guess.
Them still announcing, hey, the music will come on, and then you walk guys when you're ready, okay?
You know, this is the time that, you know, for you to show off a little bit. You've got prop shorts, you've got your box, and you've got your gum short. You can wear knee sleeves and you can wear ankle sleeves, but they must be one piece and they must be made of neoprene or cloth.
A lot of people are talking about James Dixon in the red corner, undefeated at 3-0 in the black shorts. Goes on against Aaron McDonnell from Manchester Predators in the white shorts, 5-2. A lot of people talking about these guys, Dave, and both from good gyms. Very interesting to see how this one plays out.
No, both guys looking very technically astute so far. I say that, he just jumps to life there, but nicely blocked by Dixon, and a beautiful little low kick of his own.
What a nice jab from Dixon there. Donald looking the more powerful of the two individuals, but Dixon looks very, very technically sound to me, Dave.
Yeah, he does look sound. I think he's having a look at that lead leg. I'm not sure if he's going to start going down. He's trying to fake his man out. Yeah, interesting first round. And, you know, you mentioned both fighters coming out of different stances there can often make the feeling out process that bit longer, because how many guys have you got in the gym that are southpaw? From James Dixon's point of view, he's dealing with a different stance there, and you can tell he's looking down and he's trying to land that inside low kick. I think that's a weapon that he's looking to get going. From McDonald's point of view, he's obviously looking to spring to life, Ben, almost cobra-like with those strikes from the outside. Tough round to score. Oh, nice right hand from Dixon.
McDonald wears it well, and there's a leg kick. misses and tries the back kick afterwards. Dixon goes back.
Face of McDonald.
Dixon's caught him with that right hand, I think, Dave. And McDonald get into a bit of a wild exchange here. And that right hand from Dixon really is money. That's where all his... There it is again. Straight right.
Right on Corbin. That was a fantastic right from Dixon.
Shortest distance between again. 2 points being the straight line. And he's hurt his man with that right hand. You can tell. Shot straight in for a takedown. And there's a lot of blood around about that nose. Mixes it up with a body kick nicely.
It's really filtering down to these younger guys that are coming through and just being at a higher technical level.
Oh, that's a big right hand. He dropped
right
his man.
Right on the button.
And here come the punches.
Machine gun finish.
Dixon is swarming his man.
Leon Roberts taking a close look. He's clutching for the single for his life.
There's that right hand again, and he's gone in. McDonald's really struggling
Leon
here,
Roberts
Dave.
Roberts is right on cue.
Dixon this is opening up, and that is all she wrote. What a finish from James Dixon. That right hand was money, and once he hurt his man, he was relentless in pursuing that finish, Dave.
He really was. What a prospect we have here. Dixon's right hand was on point throughout that round, but when he smelt blood, Ben, he just dropped it two or three gears and went crazy on him. Wow, what a finish.
So I train at Lions Gym. That's kind of like my main base. But I also do kind of outreach in other gyms. So I try and learn from specialists in their areas. So I also train at a number of other gyms in Coventry. And also go to Leicester and places like Wolverhampton to train regularly as well. So I kind of chose Lions Gym because, well, really, I started off at, you know, quite a terrible gym, a karate-based gym, when I didn't really know much about the sport. But then as I started to learn a bit more, I realised it wasn't the right place to be. And as I did, you know, I wasn't just doing it as a hobby. I wished to take it a little bit further than just a hobbyist would. I started to look for different places. And as soon as I walked through the doors at Lions, you know, I was literally at home. They treated me like a family. I mean, their coaches are on a very high level and they do look out for my best interests. So, you know, it's literally as soon as I walked through the door, I knew that that was going to be my base.
Clear the arm, head and shin. So remember, left hand on the shin, left hand on the shin. So this is going to be used to pull that shin. So as you shrimp and push off the head, yeah, see, so you're getting the angle. Now keep that tight, lock over. Good, now you can pull and bridge your hips.
I mean, I've got a number of trainers. I try and get a coach in every aspect of martial arts, really. So I've got Jimmy Wallhead and Andre Winner, who teach me, you know, MMA as a sport. Jimmy, I mean, he's fought pretty much on most promotions you can name. He's fought all around the world at a very, very high level, and he's consistently been England's number one welterweight, close to number one. And then also Andre, I mean, he was a runner-up in the Ultimate Fighter. And in fact, the Ultimate Fighter that got me into MMA was the Ultimate Fighter he was on. So it's almost a bit kind of crazy how, you know, how I've come across him and how he's now teaching me. But I mean, he's at the highest level as well, having fought in the UFC, again, fighting all over the world. As far as other aspects, my boxing coach is from Coventry, Adil. He's fought on the amateur circuit quite frequently, and now he's just kind of solely focusing on coaching. Also learned Thai from Dean James. I've just recently hooked up with him. He's a three-time Thai boxing champion, so he's at a very, very high level at his sport. Again, like all my coaches, they're all... It's not even being a high level at the sport. It's more about their passion and their drive. They all want me to be the best that I can possibly be, so that's why I've kind of been absorbed by them. And also, obviously, my jiu-jitsu coach as well, Wesley. He's been my jiu-jitsu coach for about 5 years now. So long, I can't even remember. But he's a black belt under Braulio Estima, who's obviously one of the highest level jiu-jitsu guys in the world. So, you know, you cannot fault his level as well. But like I said, it's my coaches. I'm very picky on my coaches. I like positive people, and I try and surround myself with all positivity. And all these coaches do 100% believe in me, and they drive me in a number of ways, and I really do look up to them.
Okay.
I realised I wanted to compete pretty much from day one. As soon as I seen it on TV, I knew that is what I wanted to do. I don't know why, I don't know, you know, nothing really crossed my mind. I just knew that that's where I wanted to be and that's what I wanted to do. I mean, it even came to a point, I wasn't even training, but at school, you know, I was meeting up with my friends and we were just wrestling in lunchtime. MMA is mixed martial arts, so I do encompass that in the fact that I try and train every single martial art. There isn't really a distinct style anymore, in my opinion. I think a lot of the styles are meshed anyway. You're taking bits from every kind of martial art, but I do kind of stick to boxing, Thai boxing, jiu-jitsu and wrestling. They're kind of my main, you know, four components that I train. It's literally a roller coaster of emotions. Literally name every emotion under the sun and you will feel it. Weeks running up to the fight, even on the day of the fight. I mean, literally, the guy you're fighting, he's the last thing on your mind before you go to bed and the first thing on the mind on your mind when you wake up. So it's kind of weird being told on that date, at that time, at that place, you're going to have a fight. It really kind of tests you mentally. But I mean, as soon as you're in that cage and that door shuts, there's only one thing that's really on your mind. Everything else is clear, and that's really, that's the rest of it.
Stand on the toes. jab, yeah, when I put it up, yeah? On the toes. Hook, yeah? Sit down. Boom! Boom! Bye-bye. And again.
I know being a fighter is probably the most humbling. Getting beaten up by another individual is probably the most humbling thing you will do. So the mentality you kind of need is you need to have a never quit mentality. You cannot go in there expect to be the best, because you'll get knocked down and you won't get back up. You just gotta keep going forward. And it is a game. It's more of a marathon than a sprint. You're in it to always learn. You're never gonna stop learning. And that's what's kind of got my attention in the fact that I love always learning. I'm a whore for knowledge, and I just always want to learn, and I never want to stop learning. And that's why I think sets me apart from a number of other individuals, really.
And his opponent, the fighter into the blue corner, Sean Watson. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise. This is the co-main event of the evening. Introducing first, the challenger from the red corner, 70 kilograms, fighting out of the Lions gym, James Dixon.
See, when you got him backed up, yeah? You got him backed up, you got hit there at the end because you waited for it, yeah? He's tired, he's getting battered, yeah? Put your foot in the foot, foot, foot!
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise, it's your fifth and final round.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a title fight. Make some noise for these two warriors. So after five amazing rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard. And we have a unanimous decision from the fighter in the red corner, the lightweight champion, James Dixon. Please make some noise for Sean Watson.
I couldn't use them.
I was tired.
No, yeah, I did a run this morning, didn't I? I had to run off the weight. My legs. You kept saying head kick. I was like, I can't kick in the head. Not right now. Nah, maybe it was from the run in the morning. No, I had to run, so now I'm away. 22-minute run. A few things to work on, but for the most part it was good, son.
What I planned previously, I knew you liked the lead up, innit? I felt that fed right into my right hand. Right. I could time the lead up, or just try and keep things and carry it a bit low.
Was it my stance as well? Was it too wide during the year?
Well, I think you might be a bit too heavy on your front foot. That's what I see. And your chin was a bit low. Especially when you come here.
I was looking at that for the fight. I was trying to work on it.
Yeah.
Obviously not enough.
Same thing though. Everything else fucking solid.
Is there anything else? Just like anything to improve on that?
Stance and maybe set up that lead up a bit better, isn't it? Maybe set it up and hide it a bit more.
Yeah, right.
But it's nice if you
get a bit higher as well, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe just move your head a bit more off that centre.
Right.
The right hand was always there.
A bit more straight.
And then on the return as well. So you go bump, bump, bump.
Yeah.
And then I'd be there already for the right hand. So
right.
Bump, 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 and get out there.
Waiting for, if not.
Yeah.
So we just waiting for inside to try to come in, and then you saw the come in.
I wouldn't really be able to say where I'll be in the future. I mean, as long as I'm doing what I love, then I'm happy. Where that takes me, whether it's Cage Warriors, UFC, Bellator, KSW, they're meaningless to me. I want to be happy. I want to know that I'm doing what I love and I'm doing it to the best of my ability. Again, this is something I've learned from my coaches and I really think it means a lot. You have to be happy. If you're not happy, there's no point to what you're doing. So where that takes me, I don't mind. Like I said, as long as I'm happy and I'm doing what I love. Wow.